Neighbors want squatters out of their posh South Tampa neighborhood, but they say the bank, which now owns the home, is not doing enough. As I-Team investigator Adam Walser reports, it's not the first time the house and its former owner have been in the center of a controversy.
He has handfuls of people in here at a time. And are they living in here? Who knows what they're doing?
Josette Height tried to rent the South Tampa home from attorney James Clark in 2016, paying a hefty deposit and rent. That eventually ended in a lawsuit when they weren't allowed to move in.
When we pulled up with the movers, he barricaded himself inside the home.
Now Clark still won't leave, even though the bank took back the house at a foreclosure auction last week.
James, you want to talk to us about this, please?
Clark isn't living alone. One roommate filed bankruptcy the day before the auction trying to stall the sale, but the court didn't grant it. We saw small children and others still living there.
You don't know anything about it? Who's living here? Do you have any idea?
Clark hasn't paid his mortgage in more than a decade.
He was once an attorney, a bankruptcy foreclosure attorney. He knows how to work the system and he's working it to his advantage at this point.
He's no longer an attorney because he surrendered his law license last year after the Florida bar discovered he spent nearly $1 million of his client's money in places like casinos, gun stores, and fancy restaurants. Records show that in the past 2 years, cops have been called to the house 25 times. Among those calls, suspected drug use, disturbances, and illegal parking.
I'm just surprised nothing's been done about it quite yet, you know? It's crazy.
Definitely concerning to know that's a regular occurrence.
The bank needs to come in. They need to put a lock on this door and get these people out of this home.
The bank that bought the house at auction is a trustee for the bank that held the original loan. We let them know about neighbors' complaints, but we haven't heard what they plan to do. Clark and his tenants were informed about the sale last week when it happened, and police were back here at the property again Sunday night. But police say it'll be up to the bank to file any possible criminal charges against the squatters. Reporting from South Tampa, Adam Walser, ABC Action News.